Hello, this is Simone, and welcome to AroadRetraveled. Let's go! AroadRetraveled. Several episodes back, we had a wonderful guest, author, photographer, and most of all, world traveler, Brandon Wilson, who talked to us about his latest book, Along the Tempe Trail, where he walked from Dijon, France, all the way to Jerusalem on a pilgrimage of peace. In that episode, Brandon also spoke about his other incredible and daring pilgrimage, also on foot, across Tibet, from Lhasa to Kathmandu, Nepal. Take a look.
I've been traveling all my life. I like to say I started at the age of 6 in the back of a Chevy as my dad and I drove cross-country from the East Coast to California. I think my major journey started with a trek that I took with my wife across Tibet in 1992. So after being more or less a world traveler with a backpack and for years before that, I had been working off a mental list of places I wanted to see because I've always been fascinated by the world and more so our interconnectedness, how things that evolve and happen in Egypt can affect us here or likewise in China. So after working through my mental list and having this sort of travel smorgasbord of experiences, I was looking for something different and something more intense and something that connected with the people who lived in a place in a more real way. And the trip across Tibet really showed me how travel can be more than just an experience of seeing something, but also an experience of living something, of growing mentally, physically, spiritually all at the same time, and hopefully having some sort of an impact on the environment. The book Yak Butter Blues is a travel diary, it's a travel log, it's a true accounting, both the good and the bad of this experience, because there were certainly ups and downs. And I guess I'm a different sort of travel writer. You know, I think enough has been said about beautiful sunsets and gorgeous landscapes and the smiling, friendly people. Of course, these things exist, but I like to present all sides of the experience, not only the good, but the bad and the human positive aspects as well as the negative aspects in other people and myself as well. And there were real moments where we really had to question whether or not we were even going to survive it.
Today, Brandon Wilson is back to tell us more about his adventures in Tibet and the book that he wrote about it, Yak Butter Blues. Hello, Brandon. It's great to have you back on the show.
Hi, Simone. It's good to be back with you and your viewers today.
I read your book, Yak Butter Blues, and I must say I finished it in only a day and a half. Usually it takes me 3 weeks to read a book, but I just couldn't put it down. With each page, I thought someone's going to die or something equally bad. Of course, I knew it wouldn't be you, otherwise we wouldn't be here on this show. We'd be on another show channeling spirits from beyond or something. Anyway, I enjoyed every page of your book. I think it's a great book for anyone who's into experiencing adventures, suspense, courage, and most of all, exploring exotic and dangerous unknown parts of the world. And you've covered all of those and then some in your journey. So Brandon, could you tell our viewers what inspired you to trek across Tibet and about the challenges you had to overcome even before you're able to embark on your journey?
I guess our trip across Tibet began in a library in Colorado. I was reading this book and I read about a trail that the Tibetan people had taken once from Lhasa to Kathmandu or vice versa back in the old days, and since the Chinese invasion, I was wondering if it was still open, if people could walk it anymore, and in fact if any Westerners had ever walked it before. I decided to contact the Chinese embassy and see if this was possible, and they sent me back a letter with a list of reasons why it was totally impossible. There was no place to stay, there was nothing to eat, the altitudes were too high, the temperatures were too severe, there was no place to stay, we couldn't speak the language. And you know, the more they gave us reasons why we couldn't do it, the more I felt compelled to prove them wrong. So my wife and I decided to fly to Kathmandu. We tried to approach it from there. We tried to get visas there, and if they didn't permit that, then we decided we would sneak into Nepal and try it on our own. It just so happened that when we arrived, we reapplied at the embassy in Kathmandu, and they said, "Your timing is most fortunate because the border opened yesterday for the first time in decades." So it was a first instance of sort of serendipity for us along that trail. You know, there was an interesting thing that happened, Simone. Although this trip started out as an adventure, and in fact, the great adventure, by the time we were ready to leave Lhasa, we looked around us and saw the conditions there, and we felt compelled to help do something about it. So we bought a set of prayer flags with the idea of carrying those with us back to Nepal, and if we made it, and at that point it was a big question, if we made it, we would try to present those to the King of Nepal to fly there as a symbol of solidarity with the Tibetan people. So we were actually not only taking this challenge on for ourselves, but we wanted to walk for the Tibetan people who couldn't do such a walk themselves and walk it in their stead.
Who were the original pilgrims who crossed Tibet, and what was the significance for it? Do you happen to know?
I think the original people who walked on this path were pilgrims who walked from Lhasa to Kathmandu or from Kathmandu to Lhasa to visit Buddhist holy sites along the way. It has a long tradition where many common Tibetan people did this, and oftentimes they would travel the whole distance on their hands and knees, rising to fling themselves forward, land on their hands, and then sliding their body forward, almost inchworming along the way.
Through your encounters with the local Tibetan people, we get a rare first-hand understanding of the people we almost never get to see or hear about. What impressed you most about the Tibetan people?